I'm going to show you how to make a dynamic range in Excel. So we have a sheet here and it's got 25, 36, 41, 44. And so what we're going to do is we'll just select these values and we'll call them random numbers. N-U-M. Okay. And press enter. And so then, if we wanted to, we can, when we've named the range, we can do things like sum. And then you you enter random. And there you have your random numbers right there, right? And then you close your bracket, and then you're good. And that's the sum of those numbers. Now, so if these numbers are changing, if you add another number to this list, it wouldn't change. It wouldn't add that one on. And so what we're going to do is we're going to change that. And what we're going to do is we are going to, I'm going to show you how it's done. And basically, it's based on two formulas. One is the count A, which is asking you how many non-blank characters are in this row. So what we're going to do is we'll show you count A. So in the E column, I'm going to run the count A function, which is going to define or tell me how many non-blank cells I have in this column. So I'm going to A colon dollar sign A. So it's going to tell me within the A column how many non-blank there are. And so we'll say OK. And you can see that it's telling you 4. And so what you're going to do is you're going to define your range by using this function here. So what we're going to do is we've named this range, random number. So we're going to go to the formulas, the formula tab here, and we're going to go to the name manager. So what I'm going to do is I am going to build my formula with the function argument box so that you can see what I'm trying to do. And this is what I'm going to put in the name manager. So the reference cell is A1, and we're going to absolutely reference that. Okay, and the rows are 0. And the columns are 0. We're doing an offset here. And the height, this is where we put our count A function in. So what we're going to do is we're going to go count A, and we're going to go A or dollar sign A colon dollar sign A and end of bracket. So that's always going to change. And the width is 1. Okay, so I'm going to say okay, and that, this is not what we're trying to do. But this explains the formula that I'm going to enter in my name box. So what we can do is we'll say okay. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this formula and copy it. And then I'm going to go and then I'm going to go to my name manager, and I'm going to go to random numbers, and I'm going to edit it, and then I'm going to put this formula in here and say okay and close. Okay, so now with this formula in here, if I put another number in here, notice my 146 is going to change to 201, and the count A is going to change to 5. So that's how you make a dynamic range. Please subscribe.